Hi and welcome to another video. So today we have another wizard video for you guys, and today we'll be looking at an NVR. So this is a network video recorder, and this is designed really for IP PoE cameras, especially for Hikvision ones. And we have the 4-channel we're looking at right now, and the model number for this one is the DS-7604NI-K1/4P. So this is there's not too many 4-channel NVRs on the market from Hikvision, but this is the most popular one. So what we're going to quickly run through you the wizard today, and just do a couple of basic settings like change the resolution and go through a couple of the menus. Okay, so we've plugged in our NVR, and this is our welcoming screen. So we have to put in a password. So we'll put in our password, admin. Admin 123. Oh, I cannot contain admin, you see. Okay, so let's change it. So let's go SSR CCTV 123. Okay. Let's put it in again. One, two, three. Okay. So now we set the password. And camera activation password. Okay, this is quite an important one, because let me quickly explain how IP cameras work with the NVR. So the IP camera password must match the camera activation password here. So if we have a brand new camera and we put this activation password as password, whatever it is, that password will be adopted by the camera when you plug it in, providing it is a new camera. But what will happen is, if the camera has already got a password, say from another NVR, or you've programmed it to a different password, it's just simply not going to work on your NVR. You have to change the password to let them match. We always recommend factory reset your IP cameras and then run the wizard on the NVR, plug in your cameras, and you can't go wrong. Okay, don't forget to put in an email address here. Okay, so if you do forget your NVR password, you'll be able to reset it. Okay. Then we go activate. Okay then, so we have now put the password on NVR, and we can run a pattern if you like, but I'm going to show you guys how to turn off the password in a little bit. So we're going to go do not use unlock pattern. Okay, now we select our time zone, United Kingdom, and we're going to run NTP, so it just syncs the time for us nice and easy. Okay, next. Okay, DHCP is enabled already. That's perfect, that's what we want. That means we can easily go online with the app. Okay, so we go next. Okay, so this is the app page. Okay, we have a lot of videos on how to get the app on your phone. I'll quickly go through it now. But what you want to do is enable it here. Okay, this is your QR code for the app. Okay, if you're not too sure what it is, we recommend you go to the Hikvision website, or just Google Hik-connect. That's Hik-connect. And download the app and then just quickly run through it. It's pretty straightforward. Like I said, we've got many videos on how to do this, so please check them out. I'll put a link below as well, just in case. We go okay then. So we need to also set the verification code. So this is a code that when you get the app, it will ask you for it, so no one else can access your DVR remotely. So we're just going to put in CCTV 123. Okay, and confirm that. So that's our activation verification code done. Okay, as you see here, it still says offline, so this is not good. So what we have done is connected this to the internet. It can be a little bit slow on going online, so just be patient. But the 99% of the time, if there is an issue with offline, it's a cable issue or a router issue. It's rarely the recorder. So let's go next and we'll come back. And you see now it's gone online. Perfect. Okay, just a little bug there, but it all works fine. All right, then we go next. Okay, now these IP cameras that's found on the network, we won't be doing this because it's a PoE NVR. We're going to run the camera straight in there. So we can go next. Okay, this is our hard drive. Most of you guys, if you haven't installed a hard drive in your NVR, I'll put a link below how to store a hard drive. It's really easy, and what you do is just click on the hard drive, click on initialize, yes, and now it's going to format the hard drive and have a nice blank hard drive. And if you're not too sure how the recording works for an NVR, or automatically set the hard drive up to record 24/7, and it will fill up the hard drive and then start rewriting the oldest data first. So there's not much you have to do there. It's pretty easy nowadays. And we go finish, and that's the wizard run. So now on our main menu, we have no cameras plugged in. As you can see, we're just gonna go through a couple of basic settings right now and get you set up. So on this icon here, configuration, bottom left corner, we go to expert mode. Okay, so expert mode, now we can get all our menus and everything. First thing we're gonna do is we are gonna go lock screen password, we're gonna turn the password off. Yes, that's fine. Okay, we have no password now, but it's not gonna keep bugging us all the time. All right, so a couple of basic settings here. We've got the date. I prefer to have day, month, year. Change the mouse speed, speed it up a little bit. Okay, system time. Okay, we can set that. You can set all the time and dates and everything. Okay, but what we wanna do here is our monitor resolution. Okay, so this is, it's coming up to 4K, this little DVR, NVR, which is nice. But as you see, it comes preset for the lowest resolution, okay? So what we recommend is go up to your highest possible quality for your monitor. Most of the most common options will be 1080p 4K. Select that one and then click on apply. I can't do it here because it will restart my recording software, but that's a pretty easy one. Okay, so daylight savings time here, you can enable this. And as you see, April, the last Sunday in April and October, it will update the missing hour. And basic settings here, we can rename the device here, we can just call it home recorder or whatever you like. Okay, it's up to you. Okay, that's the base, some of the basic settings done. Okay, so we could change our live view, our user information. If you want to change your password, you can go here. Okay, so let's go to our live view. As you see, we have no cameras plugged in, but we have different options here. You can go 1x1, 1+1. 2x2, go full screen, auto switch, so you're going to get a nice little rotation on the cameras. I don't know if you've been on the bus and seen the screen on there. It's exactly, they use auto switch, the rotating camera. Okay, we got a phone call coming in, but that's all right. Okay, but that's some of our basic settings done. And I hope you guys know how to set up an NVR now. And see you next time. Cheers. Thank you.